continuing to feel better, and she, like her husband, who was with her throughout the day, is said to be immensely grateful for the good wishes the couple have received. While Kate continues to be treated for the debilitating form of morning sickness that she is suffering from, significant changes in the rules governing the royals have moved a step closer. The Deputy Prime Minister, Nick Clegg, said a bill would be introduced as rapidly as possible, which would ensure that if William and Kate's firstborn is a girl, she will become queen and not lose out to a younger brother.
NATO has approved a request from Turkey for surface-to-air missiles to counter any threat from the conflict in Syria. Shells continue to stray over the border. Earlier, a school in a refugee camp outside Damascus was hit by shells, killing around 30 people. Both government forces and rebel fighters blamed each other. In the Egyptian capital Cairo, tens of thousands of people have been demonstrating outside the presidential palace against President Morsi. They claim he seized too much power. The Prime Minister has told newspaper editors that the clock is ticking on statutory regulation of the press and that they must set up a new watchdog urgently. Industry figures will meet again tomorrow to discuss their response to the Leveson report, which recommended a law to underpin a new regulatory framework. The number of confirmed cases of the winter vomiting bug, norovirus, is 64% higher than at this time last year. Figures from the Health Protection Agency suggest that at least more than 660,000 people have contracted the illness. Dr. Bob Adak from the HPA says it's not clear why there are more cases.
We've got no indications. Our colleagues who look at the viruses very closely have said that there don't appear to be new strains emerging this year. It's gone up this year compared to last year. Last year was a low year.
BBC News at 3 minutes past 8. Our next is at 9.